U.S. President Barack Obama returns to Africa this week, only the second visit of his presidency to the continent. VOA senior White House correspondent Dan Robinson reports that in Senegal, South Africa and Tanzania, he will stress support for democracies and economic progress and speak about the importance of human rights.
Mr. Obama has spent less than 24 hours in sub-Saharan Africa, an all-too-short visit to Ghana in 2009. He spoke to Ghana's parliament about democracy, opportunity, and peaceful resolution of conflict, and pointed to what he called a fundamental truth.
Development depends on good governance. That is the ingredient which has been missing in far too many places for far too long. That's the change that can unlock Africa's potential.
In Senegal, Mr. Obama's first stop, his host is President Macky Sall, who visited the White House last March with other African leaders. Senegal and other stops reflect U.S. support for emerging democracies, food security, global health, and fighting AIDS. Mr. Obama also is likely to speak about joint counterterrorism efforts with African nations and threats from Islamist extremists in places like Mali and Nigeria. Deputy National Security Advisor Ben Rhodes says President Obama is aware of the disappointment that he has visited Africa only once and is determined to change that.
And the U.S. would be ceding its leadership position in the world if the President of the United States was not deeply engaged in Africa. And that's what he's going to do.
Former Bush administration top official for Africa, Jindai Fraser, now with the Council on Foreign Relations, says the African street and many leaders feel let down.
That he hasn't been more engaged, that he hasn't had more dialogue with them, and that his administration hasn't had greater influence, and, you know, particularly when they compare that to the significant engagement that they're finding coming out of China.
Julius Ogbo with the Brookings Institution credits Mr. Obama with strengthening democratic institutions, peace and security initiatives, and food security initiatives. He says Mr. Obama bolstered U.S. aid levels, but Africans remain disappointed with low levels of direct U.S. investment.
Africans in the majority have been very disappointed by the fact that the U.S. is not investing enough in the continent, which would have helped to provide jobs for its millions of unemployed young graduates.
In South Africa, which White House officials call the continent's iconic democracy, Mr. Obama will discuss economic and democratic progress. He will also likely meet ailing former President Nelson Mandela. Again, former U.S. official for Africa, Jindai Fraser.
South Africa is the largest economy in sub-Saharan Africa. It has strong democratic institutions, although challenged. Certainly, there are major challenges in South Africa, but it's of strategic importance to the United States. It has a big influence in the African Union and across the region, particularly in southern Africa.
Deliberately left off Mr. Obama's itinerary was Kenya. Kenya's President Uhuru Kenyatta and Deputy President faced trials in the International Criminal Court on charges linked to post-election violence in 2007. Dan Robinson, VOA News, The White House.